Sunshine of Your Love by Cream. So there's really only two main parts to the song, and the way that I teach, not just the song, but any tune in general, is to break down the guitar parts specifically, and then go and listen by ear and understand how that gets plugged into the tune. Because trying to learn something, I talked about this in another scale drill video, like trying to learn something from beginning to end is always going to set you up to fail if you have, if you only know to do that. So if you screw up in the middle of the song and then you have to go back to the beginning, you want to break that habit immediately, right? Being able to locate where you need to go no matter what, and being able to hear the tune, even if it's not playing, right? Just have it going in your mind, in your ear. So it starts off just with single notes. I'm at the 12th fret here, just working out of D minor pentatonic. So it's 12, 10, 12, and then string 5, 12, 11, 10, and then 10, 13, 10. Now this little bit right here, be replaced whenever you want, or substituted with this string 4 fret 12 and string 3 fret 10. Clapton does that all the time. You can just kind of mix and match. It doesn't have to fit the recording exactly. Just kind of do it based on feel, whatever you think sounds good. It's the same notes, so they're just an octave apart. So the single notes here gets replaced by, I was playing in the earlier part of the video, I was playing four strings, so I was actually getting a D major and C major chord in there, but we'll just talk about it in terms of a three finger power chord. So I've got fret 10 on string 6, string 5 fret 12, and string 4 fret 12, with fingers 1, 3, and 4. So basically gets replaced by the power chords, and then everything else is the same, or so once you actually get into the part where the lyrics start, we'll call this the D riff. Going to repeat four times, or be played four times, and then you go to the G riff, which with the power chord shape, you just drop it one string set, and that's it. It's all the exact same thing. G5 to F5, just down a whole step, from 10 here to 8 here, and then finger 3 on string 4 fret 12, 12, 11, 10, and then on string 5, 10 and 13. So G5, F5, 12, 11, 10 on string 4, 10 and 13 on string 5. You play that twice, and then back to the D riff twice. So that's D riff four times. Entire verse. So every time you hear a verse come around, that's what's being played. Then it goes to the chorus. I'm just going to jump down here to frets 5 and 7, A5 power chord, just down, up, down, down, up, down, and then C5, I'm on string set 5, 4, 3 here, this is at frets 3, 5, 5. String set 6-5-4, G5, A5, C5, and that gets played three times. So I time, you just strum down on your A5 chord for two measures, or 16 down strums, and then you're back into the D riff, and it starts all over again. There's nothing that deviates there. The only thing is towards the end of the song, I think they'll actually repeat the chorus part like a couple more times because they're just kind of vamping on it or putting a little coda and stretching it out. But that's pretty much it. So we're using three-finger power chords there. You can totally use two-finger power chords, right? Just string set 6 and 5 for the D5 there. And string set 5 and 4 for the G5, F5. Alternate picking. As you're going into the riffs there. And you can give that a little bend there. So let me know if you have any questions. There's not really anything too tricky about transitions because there's a lot of time in between the riffs. As long as you put your D riff and G riff together there, you understand where it's located. Should be pretty easy, I think. Let me know if you have any questions, guys. Have fun with that. Take time putting it together, you know. Don't rush it, but just make sure you're understanding the song form. Think about those parts that we went through, and then go listen to the song and make sure that you're hearing all of those parts, and that's going to get stuck in your ear, and it's going to be a lot easier to remember. Alrighty, see you guys in the next video. Thanks.